welcome to the Captain's videoblog. We are Tuesday, May the 10th, 2016. It's 4:20 in the morning. Oh boy, this joke has been old for a month. Almost. Yeah. So, I thought that I would get better at, you know, going to bed early because I have to wake up early. Turns out I'm not quite able of doing that. I really don't know why, you know. At 2 a.m. I was in front of, you know, this TV program about football, and it had ended, and I was like, well, I'm gonna wait for my father to wake up and to leave, and then I will be able to film my shit. Except, well, I mean, there's one thing that I should really, you know, consider, because in most times it's the case, it's that when my father's alarm clock rings, doesn't mean that he's getting up now. Usually it takes him around 20, 30 minutes. Even if it's 2:05, 2:10, I have more than enough time to film a video, especially in that case, in a case like today, where despite doing, you know, the usual cleanup, I still have enough shit on my phone to only have around 10 minutes of video recording in front of me. So, you know, I realized something, and it's not because I just watched it, it's because, you know, I realized it quite some time ago, but, I mean, every time when I tried to talk about it in a video weblog, it just popped out of my head, for some reason. I mean, there was something that I wanted to talk about today, but I totally forgot about it. There's this anime called Big Order that's currently airing, and you know, usually an anime will have a website, and I think that this time it's because another work by the same author, because it's an adaptation of a manga, has been adapted into an anime, and that anime and those two animes have been made by the same studio, I would guess, because the website of Big Order is a subsection of the website of Future Diary, which is, you know, kind of a cheap way out, especially considering just how open the ending of Future Diary is, you know, something that is quite, I mean, that is quite shit. Everyone was saying, you know, at the end of Future Diary, there was this announcement that the author was working on something else. A lot of us thought that it would be a sequel, you know, just to explain, because if anything, Future Diary is highly unsatisfactory, you know. Obviously, it's, you know, it's, and I will say something that I would probably not have said a couple years earlier, when it was pretty much the only series that I had watched from start to end in pretty much one go, so that I marathoned, which is, it's pretty much shit. It's edgy. You don't feel like anything has been accomplished, and when there's plot advancement, it's not good, you know. So yeah. Oh god. So yeah, Big Order's website is a subsection of the Future Diaries website, and I find this pretty funny, and like, wow, you're pretty cheap, huh, aren't you? I don't even know the studio that makes it. It would be even funnier if the studio that made Big Order wasn't the same as the studio that made Future Diary 4 years ago, approximately. Yeah. Yeah. So, What happened today? Well, I made the chart. It was pretty cool. People seemed to react to it pretty well, I guess. I mean, that's pretty much all I'm looking for, you know, people theorizing, making some conclusions, you know, from the chart, the charts, how the scenarios make sense or not, you know. Like, one scenario that's highly unlikely is that C would qualify, because they would need to win by at least two more goals than VR, if VR wins, to be safe and not have, you know, the goals for tiebreaker. And something that's probably as unlikely is W and A both qualifying, because it would take a lot of score, you know, a lot of goals, not only from both teams, but also like having a huge lead over Int and TRV, which is something that might not happen, you know. But then again, there's always the thing with the goals for differential, which is, you know, complicated to overcome in the case of TRV and W, because TRV has like 11 goals for, while Int has like 6 goals for. But an A win pretty much would put them in contention for a qualification. The only way A would not qualify is really if they lose. But yeah, they play first on Saturday, well, of the group on Saturday, and once the match is over, well, we'll see. Yeah, what was there? Oh yeah, there was the Eurovision Song Contest. Well, not the the Song Contest in itself, but the first semifinals. Like, it's been like that since 2004, I think, because there are a lot of countries that want to take part in Eurovision, and just not to make the whole thing way too long to air on TV. Well, they make some qualification rounds. Like 40 teams in the semifinals, 20 in the first, 20 in the second. 10 qualify from the first, 10 qualify from the second. They join the big five, which is France, Italy, Germany, Spain, and Great Britain. And the winner of the previous edition of the Song Contest, this time is Sweden. So it's like 46 teams, 26 teams, 26 countries. I mean, this year the person who will represent France is a French Israeli singer called Amir. And he's been like in the finals of a song contest already once, that he lost. But at the same time, that song contest was only decided by the votes of the public. This time, it's all of Europe that decides if we win or not. So that's a little bit more pressure. When I say all of Europe, I think that even Australia might take part, because they have, last year they were invited and they were directly in the finals. This year they are still invited, but they're like in the, they have to go through a semi-final. Maybe because at one point we realized that Australia was just too good for Europe. I still wonder, at one point we're going to decide that maybe we should invite the United States then. I think that one of the main reasons why Australia is invited is because, well, they're still pretty much a colony of England. Colony. Of England, you know, being ruled by the Queen and all, Commonwealth, whatnot. Yeah, and well, I mean, this year I don't know what happened, but there are way, and I mean, way less wacky acts. You know, like countries that send a singer that takes themselves seriously. Apparently, Germany sends a weeb. That's I mean, you cannot describe it as anything else. She, the singer, she dresses like one of those Harajuku idols, you know. Except she's German. So yeah, that's the only kind of I don't know. There was the woman from Croatia with her strange dress. She looked like a JRPG boss, and she even changed forms at one point. Was like, haha, this is not even my final form. This is my final form. I don't remember really who advanced. I think there was Armenia, because they I remember that Armenia advanced because they were really happy, and they flew a flag of the Nagorno-Karabakh region, which is officially like in Azerbaijan. I hate Azerbaijan in Eurovision. Don't get me started on Azerbaijan in the Eurovision Song Contest. So yeah, this region is officially part of Azerbaijan, but it's mostly populated by ethnic Armenians, and that's kind of a problem, because I think it's also kind of occupied by the Armenian army or something like that. There was a war at the end of the USSR. What's my cat doing? God damn it, what a crazy cat. Stop it. So yeah, there was also Austria, because I remember that Austria has a song in French which is, you know, sung well. I mean, she has no accent, but the lyrics are pretty shitty, if I must say so. She sings about, oh, I want to go to another country, and we sing and we dance. I will follow you to this other country. I mean, okay, I will probably vote for you when time comes, because I cannot vote for France since I'm French and I'm living in France. But that's pretty much the only reason why I would vote for Austria this time around, because she sings in French. Cyprus went through with a song that really, at some parts, really sounded like the song from The Killers. Czech Republic, Estonia didn't go through, which was kind of a bad thing, I think, because, I mean, the guy looked like he could kill you, you know? No, I don't really remember. At one point I will remember. And, you know, basically, the Eurovision Song Contest is our manner to have war without having to lay on arms. Oh yeah, there was Russia, which was booed, because that's Russia, I mean. The only place where they won't boo Russia is in Russia. What else is there to talk about in the Eurovision? Yeah, basically the way they vote is not by voting on the performance of the people. Rather, it is on how the countries are in relation to each other. That's why France doesn't usually get points from anyone, because at one point we were the big assholes in Europe. So we only have to rely on our own performances. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, I'm gonna run out of space, so thank you for watching. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.